In a previous video, I talked about the non-Jewish Messiah in modern times, which I contend is Lord Balfour. But what about the Jewish Messiah? Where is he? Shouldn't he have come right after Lord Balfour? And so when you think about the Jewish Messiah, you think about King David. He was the first, well, technically the second king of Israel. And he was a military leader that conquered the Philistines to allow peace and to allow a temple to be built. And so what do we have that in modern times? What happened in the beginning of the state of Israel? There was the War of Independence in 1947, led by the first Prime Minister, David Ben-Gurion. And he won the war and to allow more immigration of Jews to come back into the land. And he also united the different Jewish militias into the IDF forcefully. And so he was the de facto leader and he was voted as the first Prime Minister. So he does have David-like qualities. So why wouldn't he be the Jewish Mashiach? Because he didn't finish the job. He didn't finish conquering the West Bank and Gaza. At the time of 1947, he had a chance. He thought he had the ability to also conquer the West Bank and Gaza, but he decided not to because he was afraid of repercussions from the US and from Egypt. And so, and then also in 1967, Moshe Dayan, who was military leader in the 1967 war, even though we won the war and pushed Jordan and Egypt out, he still didn't want to conquer the West Bank and Gaza, again, for the same reason that he was afraid of the repercussions from the US and Egypt. And so neither of them finished the job. And so, but you know what it does resemble? It resembles what happened when the Israelites first came into the land of Canaan from Egypt. And Joshua was a military leader, and he fought against the tribes, the five different tribes of the Canaanites, and defeated them to allow the Jews, the Israelites, to come back and have a space to settle in the land. But Joshua didn't finish the job. And there are many reasons why it's cited that he wasn't able to finish it. And many of the reasons are applicable to today's time. And one being that they needed the labor to help build the land. They needed help. So they left some people there and they were laborers, which we have today. And then also, it stated that it didn't happen all at once because it would allow the land to be barren and not grow right. And so that's the other reason. So all of these reasons are applicable to today. And so when you think about it, history is literally repeating itself in today's time and nobody's paying attention. Nobody's paying attention. This literally happened, you know, 3,000 years ago when the Israelites came back into the land of Canaan. And so it's my contention that David Ben-Gurion is the modern day Joshua. And so where is our David? Where is our King David that will finish the job? Now, I checked, and from Joshua to David, it's 400 years. And does that mean we have to wait 400 years before we have the real Mashiach to finish off the job, and we're going to have to live in a situation with the Arabs always fighting for 400 years? God forbid, I hope not. And so maybe, is this war that we're fighting right now the start of the end of our conquering the Arabs and to have peace so that we can build the temple? Like, maybe, but not unless the current Israeli government changes and the people change in their thinking. They're already starting to change a little bit, but I don't think they're there yet. So I can only hope that in the course of time, something will happen, and we have to do one thing at a time. First Gaza and West Bank, we got Hezbollah, we have Iran to deal with. So whoever is the one who is going to be the one to finally finish the job and conquer all these enemies that surround us will be the Jewish Messiah, will be the Jewish Mashiach. So God willing, it will come soon in our lifetime.